and recover.
Because I want to see it come back and work so we can like prove everyone wrong that Amumu's actually good.
Assured me that he still thinks it's good and he might play it. So I would be very happy if he does pick it again.
We'll see if it happens. Team Impulse already
banning. I gave
banning.
Him some tips for next time.
I mean, you are like the world famous Amumu engage. You are a gold medalist on Amumu.
Oh, look at this. Impulse actually banning Lulu themselves.
Yeah.
One of their biggest picks for Gate. So he will be on more influential mid laner this time around.
Eliminations Braum also gone. I think the Karma there may be a bit less afraid of this champion. It leaves up the Alistar Pinch for a first pick. Kalista, Nidalee both gone. Now the question I'm going to ask is who gets Azir if Cloud9 is forced to ban that away from Gate? It would be a probably very strong first pick.
Yeah, definitely. That would be snatched up pretty quickly. Incarnation definitely wouldn't shy away from playing something like Victor as well. So Cloud9 very well could let it go through.
And there's Sneaky's Tristana gone. Now both these guys have shown they are happy to play Ashe. She might even go away in the first round. Yeah. And wow, Rush's Evelynn is gone, which means Azir is up. And I think you just locked the one in impact.
Yep, 100%. So Incarnation will probably play Victor, and they can just save that pick. Jump on some earlier priority here first. All the jungle focus. Makes sense to get a second round here.
Well, I think the picks and bans really made sense. You saw a clear goal from both sides. Cloud9 understood what was still very important for both these teams. The Elise with the Evelynn gone, the Ashe, the Tristana ban. They gave away the Azir, traded those two, and now we get into the very interesting parts of Champ Select where the teams have to put their comps together.
It actually is pretty interesting because Cloud9 showing a lot of pick already. Versus Team Impulse. they were very impressed with Chai's Hai's champion pool. Mm-hmm.
There's a Shyvana hover as well. This is what Cloud Templar goes through every single game he casts, by the way. People hover his champion pools. Let him know what's going on. Rush, known very much for his Lee Sin. We'll see if he ends up going for that champion or if he's actually going to go back to playing the tanks that he didn't do very well on last playoffs back in spring, but he's going to lock in the Gragas, and Shen comes through, likely for Impact.
Yeah, it's been one of Impact's favorite champions for a long time. Plays a really good Shen. Can't affect the bottom lane as well, which is what I think Team Impulse should go for in the match versus Cloud9.
Ooh.
Trying to take over Sneaky and Lemon Nation's map presence really early on.
You know, there's something interesting going on here. Impulse have been really happy to play Kog'Maw over and over and over again. The Janna's still up. They've got a Shen to help him stay alive. Like, Kog'Maw has a good comp built around him. Though at the same time, I've seen that teams really like playing Ashe into Kog'Maw and trying to either pressure him or the other lanes where he's not and try to really play that aggressive pick style. So this might really kind of coalesce into those styles in the last five picks.
And Kog'Maw, fairly slow on his feet, so a prime target for late game Ashe arrows, as is Azir. But Azir will probably take cleanse. I don't know if Apollo will actually want to run cleanse for the early part of the game. But yeah, back to Rush's Gragas. Actually, haven't been very impressed with it when I've seen him in solo queue on it either. But he's confident this time around to take it in. We'll see if he can perform here. I really thought that he was going to be a big part of Impulse's advantage over Cloud9, and if he's not comfortable on the champion, that might take away from it. But obviously, he feels confident in picking it up early.
It's interesting seeing what Impulse is hovering now. Cloud9, it feels like they tunneled really hard on making sure they could deal with a potential Kog'Maw pick, as Apollo's been playing it so much. Right, the Maokai grabbed that for some lock-in, the Janna almost a steal away if we're still tunneling on that strategy being a possibility. But now Cloud9 are a bit lighter on engage when they picked up Janna, and Impulse actually going to go for a very interesting team comp themselves. Sivir and Soraka on the same team.
It's been so long, but Apollo finally back on the Sivir that he played so much of the regular season on and sort of defined the Impulse style. Five-man moving down quickly. But this time around, they are going to have not only the Sivir movement speed for rotations, but also the Shen Global.
This is going to be interesting. So Sivir can spell shield arrows, and Soraka can stay in the back. And of course, we do have Gate right now with Cleanse. So good luck finding arrow targets for Cloud9. And I'm curious what this comp's going to come together as. I don't think they can really out-backline an Azir. So the question is, what's their team comp going to do? You said Victor at the very start, pick him up at the very end. No rush on that.
Yeah, Victor would be good because bursting down people is also great when the other team has Soraka.
They can get through it. Oh, no, it's an entirely different look. The Varus.
Okay.
Pope Tom comes through.
Is it an Ash? No, just kidding.
No, it's not. We're not in 2009, Kobe. TP Ashmid is no longer a common champion.
All right. Well, they are going to have some Poke here. And Poke has been one of the earliest counters to Azir that arose back when he was at his strongest, trying to poke him out in lane and chunk him down before the fights even start. So we'll see how good Incarnation's lane phase is and how good his accuracy is with the arrows, because it actually is a very good champion versus Azir, one of the earlier ones that did emerge. If you can land a couple of those, you can take him out of the team fight before it even begins.
Yeah, and we saw Steve having some very good Maokai TP home guards earlier today, so certainly Balls can do a lot here as well.
Yeah, the other thing is, though, that Impulse do have Soraka, so if they get poked out, Soraka is a great counter to that poke. So Cloud9, if they hit one, they're going to have to immediately initiate with the Ash Arrow and the Maokai. Good thing for Cloud9 is that they do have those really reliable initiation tools that they can just use at the snap of a finger.
Absolutely true. So we're going to see how these teams can actually fight on the Rift today. Now, you guys at home, warm up those Twitter accounts and keep sharing your series predictions with each game. Send hashtag TIPWin or hashtag C9Win to @LOLEsports, and we'll update the fan poll throughout the games here. Now, two best of fives sit between either of these teams and a spot at the World Championship this year. Team Impulse, Cloud9 doing battle. Here we go into game one.
All right, let's see if Cloud9 can get those picks. They are going to be very heavily reliant on catching people out. But if they do, they have got plenty of CC to stack. See if Rush tries to focus Impact's lane as usual to try and get that Shen ahead.
It's true, it's been one of the strongest things for Impulse really all season long, that top jungle synergy. It carried them very far. Rush had the option of playing Lee Sin, didn't go for it. Was Nidalee even banned?
Nidalee and Evelynn were both banned, and Elise was taken away from him. So.
Okay. I forgot if the Nidalee was shown there. So, drop to his third choice here, essentially.
30 seconds until minions spawn.
It looks like a semi-deep invade for Cloud9. They're just getting basically camp watching wards down. Gate loses his first trade to Incarnation. These players are now both 100% of their team's damage champions. That will go down over time, I can say with certainty.
True statements. All right, so the deep wards, semi-deep wards we'll put in, just at the jungle camps to see where both teams are going to be starting. Maokai does stack the saplings for Incarnation. She'd be able to get that experience lead with a single arrow. Not actually going back to heal, whereas Gate did go, though. So he'll have maybe 20 HP advantage.
Yeah, didn't use any flask charges. He's at 460 of 550. It's not that bad. And he'll keep sustaining up. I'm sure all will be well. Easy pick up there. Gets even more health back from that. He got the mastery, as he should. So Rush and Impact are going to be duo juggling the bot side and their own duo lane, Apollo and Adrian, not taking any XP for themselves. This all gets spotted by the C9 wards.
And this may signal that Rush is planning on focusing top lane, because they're clearing out the bottom half of the jungle first with the top laner tanking. So Rush will be at full health, and he can end his route on the top side very easily and have plenty of health to go for a gank. As he said, Cloud9 saw the start, though. So I think that Hai should take this information and try and kill Soraka early. It's one thing that people always complain about Soraka lane, and her laning is so oppressive and it's so difficult to deal with. Yes, in a 2v2, it's extremely difficult because she could just play far back like this and let the AD carry do all the trading and then heal him up. But she is very, very gankable.
Yeah, thankfully for the Cloud9 lane, Sivir, not much burst. You can typically shield her damage. But Hai's looking for the mid lane, looks for Gate. He has cleanse.
He lands
so
the
much
red
damage
buff
through. Force a flash before Repel Q could land.
Wow.
Didn't have Repel, actually. It's Q and W, but whatever.
Huge chunk, though. That was a very successful mid gank from Hai. Able to get not only the summoner, but enough health as well before the flash was forced to send him back to base even. And that is very big for Cloud9.
Yeah.
If Varus could get out in front of the Azir, he'll get to that level 9, maxing his Q even quicker that we talked about for poking him down, and can provide a lot of map control, especially for an Elise. If your mid laner can continually chunk down the enemy, it can open it up for high.
Absolutely, and we talked yesterday about mismatches between the two teams. That Incarnation would likely do better than Gate, but also that Rush should be better than high. And right now, high has out-pressured Rush, forced a flash, forced a recall, and we still wait to see what this Gragas will do in this game.
Yeah, I mean, it's like Rush went for the hard farming, so
yeah.
It's the fact that high just got such a quality gank in there. Typical mid laner turn jungler, ganks for the mid lane.
Ganks the mid lane.
But yeah,
we're in a mid laner too.
Rush Rush does have the camp advantage as he, you know, hard farmed the rest of them. See what he does with it. Maybe he'll be the one to go bottom.
Ah, true. See what happens here. Soraka does have a delayed route. Maybe she can set up a kill for the team. Right now, just the lane pushed in Cloud9, running around looking for some warding, and the first recall from this Janna.
Yeah. Easy communication there to tell them that the Trinket Ward was just dropped off, so don't waste any time going for that one. Impact here, trying to deny CS by taunting while one is low.
Ooh, over the wall, no look pass from high. But Gate's able to get away before Repel can land, and all is well. That might be another recall force out of Gate.
Yes, it's another recall, and the lane is frozen up on Incarnation's side. So they are denying Gate heavily here, making it very, very difficult for him to even get experience now. He's going to have to call in Rush. This is something Rush doesn't normally do. But to come in and be the ward support for mid lane, they might even need an early pink on mid lane.
There's actually a specific part that plays out here as well. You talk about the wards, I think they need it, but also keep in mind, Varus, as well as Elise, both have hard CC, and Varus is gonna hit six well before Azir.
Yeah. Gate does have the cleanse, so but he doesn't have flash, so he'll have to
block one of them.
He'll have to move immediately after the first CC lands, hoping that Cloud9 stack them, and he'll be able to dodge it.
See how that pays out. Gate right now down 10 CS. High still showing up for the map. Wants impact, and that's going to be the route into the stun. He's now very low on Shen, dodging away. Low on mana here. No further dive will happen. Impact going to slink away, and now Rush is here. No mana on High. Here comes the trade back, and oh my god, 200 health left. High flash the way, and Rush is not far away from another body slam.
Yeah, it's. I think that's done, though. Just an exchange. Oh, there it is, the cleanse.
Instant cleanse, but still some auto attacks to land. This Q could hurt. Good dodge.
All right, well, now he knows cleanse is down. He can call down high. See if he can come in. Gate has warded the top side river, though, so he should definitely hug that side of the mid lane, because knowing he has zero summoners down.
Yeah. 1 minute left on the flash.
High's got to smell blood in the mid lane. Incarnation's ult will be down, though, as well, so it's gonna it would have to be High setting up his own cocoon, which is pretty easy, or even sneaky with a cross-map arrow here. They're approaching level 6. The other thing is that we talked about how you can gank Serac, it's just very gankable. Apollo can try and walk in front of Adrian and spell shield the arrow.
Yeah.
So normally you'd think Ashe would have great gank setup here when she hits 6, but they may opt to use it in mid lane instead.
Another trade, and Apollo losing a lot of health in this one, but Adrian does not seem to care about that at all.
Got mana back with the shield, health back with the Soraka. He's
yep.
Good to go.
Didn't even matter. These AD carries very close in CS right here. Apollo holding up nicely. There was actually an interesting player tendency with Lemination. I've looked at his runes and masteries and stuff before. He actually really often runs gold generation. Like in this game, he recalled right on the money for Nomad's Medallion for the upgraded gold generation. He's going to be really rich, which will help him get the Zeke's Harbinger that he normally gets every game.
Yeah, he has always been one of those players that likes to skimp, especially even on buying wards early.
Mm-hmm.
So when Sneaky was playing a lot of Ashe, you know, he'll play Zyra even to lay down plants, anything to avoid spending money early.
They got Hawkshot, so it's fairly safe here.
Yeah, because it does pay off. The more money you invest in gold generation early, the bigger the mid-game payoff there. Lemination trying to get speed. Rush moving around. He has not been seen, by the way. All this ward coverage is in favor of Team Impulse. So this is a level 6 Gragas. Prime position.
Lemination. Wow, down to 100 health already. Summoner heals back up. Spike comes back through, and now Rush is stunned in turret range. Couple heals from Adrian, but now the team comes in. First blood for Impact. He's made that one happen, but the re-engage on towards Rush. Turret aggro, though, just on the minions, so no further damage to deal. First blood for Impulse.
Skipping on the wards, Impact able to come down as well with his ultimate and teleport used.
I'm going to see when he used teleport.
Yeah, were those both used?
He TP'd the top lane already.
Okay. So
and then and had the ulti up.
Unfortunate timing for him, but they do get the first blood there. Hi, does have Krug buff. He's going to use it. No.
It will consume it, though. He wants this, the buff to stun minions, so he takes less damage.
It does make taking Scuttler easier, but he's going to make a beeline for this blue buff. Try and punish Rush for his bottom lane gank there. Make him pay for that first blood with a blue. Impact. Looks like he's going to close the door here and hide.
Ooh. Whoa! I got it. His fight just came back up in time. Slinks away, steals the buff. Nicely done, high. And all said and done, despite the first blood, Cloud9 still slightly up in gold because this mid lane lead that high manufacture.
Yep, the mid lane, a really big part of that. Also, during the double teleport down bottom, high was able to rotate up into the top lane and take a full wave. So a full wave of minions, you know, not too much to laugh at, especially if you're a jungler.
Yeah. He's tied up rush because of that.
Very happy to grab those. So yeah, that's a CS lead, by the way. He got top lane farm.
Varying advantages throughout the map. Impact very rich here. 75 CS and first blood makes him the highest gold. But Adrian getting found out. Level 6 on Soraka. Does have flash.
Cheeky doesn't fire the arrow.
Nope. Huh. Flash still got used. You got to save the cooldown. Honestly, that seems pretty appropriate.
Well, they also got really deep wards down on that bottom side. Cloud9 definitely looked like they're prepping a move down on the bottom here.
Really,
Rush, if Rush ventures anywhere down near the red buff, we'll see him coming.
Yep.
That gold generation investment that Lemons made paid off, by the way, able to get his sight stone.
Oh!
He does have cleanse and flash, but.
There's a point blank arrow onto Apollo, though. Heals come out. The flash! Sneaky gets the kill. He's going to trade his life for it. Rush gets the kill. Thank you very much. 321 for him. Nice play.
Rush still manages to make a gank on the bottom lane.
Because they knew he was there. They saw him walk through bottom jungle.
I think he gets his target, though. So one for one trade. Impact's actually going to farm between turrets here. Maokai doesn't actually care about that at all. Maokai's just fine. He's taking a wave and AoEing it. So doesn't really get much done there. They both decide to... So much mid lane pressure here from high.
Oh, dear.
And then remember, this all stems from that early game.
Oh, trying back though. Body slam flash, not quite got a land, but Incarnation still force winner from this one. Impact flashes over. He wants this to happen. And Gate's still buying time. Adrian's alive somehow in the back line. High really wants this, but the exhaust is too much. The piercing arrow misses, and this is going from bad to worse. Impulse, wow. The flash wave, finally the kill comes through. 4-1 TIP.
Adrian keeps everyone alive in that insane skirmish there. Both High and Incarnation burning all summoners to try and snipe someone, but Impulse are able to evade them for long enough and five members collapse.
Man. All right, we've got a fun game on our hands, and it is a gold lead, though, for Impulse after all. 2-0-2 on Rush. The Gragas, you know what, it's working out. 100% KP, no deaths on him. But Sneaky's got better items. You put Apollo around. Yeah, this is a lot of damage that Apollo can't deal with.
No! Soraka comes again.
Oh, man, that's got to feel bad.
The Adrian ambulance.
Just back to full.
Just in time for some extra lane presence now.
Jeez.
That actually, even though Sneaky played it fairly well, is going to turn against them here as now Team Impulse have a bunch of tower pressure and Rush has made his way over.
Well, High says hello to him. It's going to be some scary damage back and forth though. Spiderlings take some damage. Rush walks away. And Rush does buy himself a Sight Stone. Never would have thought Rush would be a player that goes Cinderhulk Sight Stone in the game.
His Gragas has been very good, actually. So,
yeah.
Despite not being impressed by it, by it previously, definitely need to give credit where credit's due.
Okay, so far dodging what Pokey can. Remains down about 25 CS in this lane, though. It's definitely a rough one for him. Has kept himself from dying. That's solid. Incarnation, though, just farming very heavily means he needs to be an offensive factor in this game. Hi, once again, looking for something to do. Not far behind in farm, but still trying to find his first kill in the game.
Oh, yeah, they're walking into the web right now. Pink ward here, so Hi knows that he's not been seen. They really want to try and take down that mid turret so they can get start getting their deep wards in, start making those picks.
Uh-oh, Sneaky gets silenced, then here comes the engage. It's going to be Agent who pulls aggro, takes a couple of shots, walks back and says, you know what, I'll keep Rush alive. Easy tower dive there, and all is well. Gate still getting poked around. You're seeing this Varus pick definitely work thanks to Hai's help early game, but the sides of the map are getting worse and worse. Or yep. Cloud9.
Soraka's not good at starting off tower dives, but she's great at assisting tower dives. Rush able to just walk right through.
As the first turret, 3,000 gold lead for Impulse. Now fighting the top lane. Hai still trying to get himself into these battles. Impact does not have flash. There's only so much CC. There's a chance he can TP out of this one. Dodge the way into the brush. Still revealed. And Ball's going to find him again. This should be the kill. Soraka to use just to buy some time, maybe a bit fruitlessly, and Impact goes down. Balls gets the kill. Gate back in the mid lane, but the turret's already dead. He's got to raise this one up. He's not doing it. But Incarnation still not in a good spot. There's explosive cast. There's the kill. Gate gets the first of the game.
So Gate has been able to absorb 4 or 5 ganks from Hai this game without almost any influence from Rush, and he has not died. He's been able to stay alive the entire time. Yes, he's getting crushed in CS, but that's purely because of the amount of ganks, and he's able to survive until the time is right. Yes, his turret goes down.
Arrow hits a long stun, but nothing to do.
But he makes the most of it.
If he hadn't body slammed, he would have pulled aggro with the Cinder Hulk and actually taken turret shots there. That was pretty fortunate that he body slammed before the arrow hit him.
All right. See if Team Impulse can make this work. They do have Shen Teleport Stand United available right now. And this is pre-nerf Sivir, so very, very quick grouping here from Impulse is possible. They just have Impact shove down on the bottom side of the map and try and pressure this outer turret here. There should be some easy gold. With outer turrets standing like this, it's very easy to get that split push going.
Yeah, especially when Rush can just win any matchup he wants to be in. He's gigantic on this Gragas, level 9, 3, 0, and 3.
Yep, 100% kill participation for Rush. Looking to head him off, targeting the Ash once again.
Oh, Hawkshot spotted him. Looks like his damage never happened. Adrian back to happy, back to healthy. Here comes the team pushing for the top side. Paula will save Spell Shield, just dodge this tornado, but top lane turret still going to be losing a whole lot of health. Down to half, plenty of attack damage, should be going down.
And Gate can hold mid as well. He can just put back up in his ear turret if he needs to. Problem there. Clears the wave, sees Hai as well, so alerts the rest of the team. They can continue pushing.
And Impact has teleport, so we can easily show up being Shen.
Objective earned without any answer there from Cloud9. Clean pickup there for Impulse.
It actually surprised me that C9 set their dual lane topside. When they're already losing the 2-on-2, they didn't look to contest Dragon. My thought is maybe they thought Impulse would Dragon off the turret then, and they'd trade a top lane turret for it, but as the lanes matched up, just Impulse picking up another objective for nothing of C9.
Yeah. Neither team really looks like they're prioritizing Dragon stacking this game, so it will probably be down to a Siege game. Especially since Cloud9 here looking to get some deep wards for their picks, but Hai not able to cross the river.
The wards just keep dying as well. So now, at least can help, but...
Yeah, the thing is, you can make picks on your own side of the map quite easily as well. If Cloud9 keep up their defensive warding, maybe they can catch Team Impulse as Impulse are trying to keep up the pressure and they extend past the river into Cloud9 territory.
Yeah, we'll see if Impulse pushes any farther forward and opens up those opportunities. I mean, Cloud9 still has a crap ton of engage. They've got Teleport Maokai, they've got Elise, they've got Varus, they've got Ash. Missteps will be punished, but it's Rush who's ever always walking in first. No one else is getting caught out here. Cloud9 only got kills off of Sneaky trading his life for it.
You do equalize turrets here and get a little bit of harass on Impact, but with the health pot running, he actually gains life.
Always a rough situation to be in. Infinity Edge not yet done. Sneaky's actually not been back to base for quite a while. So you can see 2,000 gold. 2250 is the Infinity Edge upgrade from BF Sword, so he's got two waves to go.
Yeah.
Or Krugs in one wave, and then he'll buy a lot more damage.
Paulo actually got his Avarice Blade a lot earlier as well, and he's got an extra 100 gold from it so far.
Yeah. A lot of these guys getting very rich. Both supports. You can see already the Cloth Armor picked up for Adrian, the Amp Tome for Elimination. Almost definitely Zeke's on both sides.
Yeah. The thing is, helps. It's hard for Cloud9 to pick someone off when Shen is holding on to the Stand United.
Yeah.
Because if the Ash Arrow even hits, then Impact can still shield whoever gets caught, and a Sivir boosts speed boost for the rest of the team means they can collapse really quickly.
Yeah. And as well, like, both supports are playing kind of non-roaming supports in that they're not, like, offensive playmakers. Like, Lemon wants to sit in lane to acquire gold in the first place. Transition time, like, loses him money and thus loses combat stats on Sneaky. And so if he's not showing up with Hind, yeah, Stand United is just enough to prevent anything from really happening meaningfully here. Incarnation just sitting at that plus 20 mark. Like, Gates not really budging from that early deficit. 2,500 gold separates these two teams. And as you pointed out a little while ago, Kobe, C9 did equalize the turret score, though. That was actually pretty strong of them. Mid lane is the one turret advantage they had. Trade for the two side outers that Impulse have gotten.
Yeah.
Rush now playing inside the jungle, though. Really trying to get through high.
Impact has two completed items as well, so Split Push is also going to start taking a toll.
The cool thing for Impulse as well is it's a while to the next dragon, and so Gate could lose his cleanse and not care, really. And with Soraka, he can kind of go up and like poke turrets down, play almost overly aggressive, take an arrow, walk back, and kind of lick his wounds. I feel like it gives tools for Impulse to really continue to play the pressure game between dragons.
Well, they actually have Impact farming the jungle right now, too, so they're just trying to increase gold gain. They're not really trying to pressure secondary turrets or even this middle one that's the only one left standing as far as outers for Cloud9. This crab, not going to be... The vision not going to last till dragon either, so... Not much gain there. This is pretty much all going to come down to will Cloud9 commit to a pick before any action breaks out, because Impulse are very happy just to continue to soak up gold here.
It's rough. Like, it's also weird because all of Impulse's gold lead is on their jungler.
An arrow from a brush, very, very difficult to spell shield.
Yeah.
Apollo's not paying attention. Plus, even if he does, Maokai's there to follow up.
All summoners up on all sides, not counting smites. All ulties as well. See, next fight, if it happens, we'll have all cooldowns available. Easy wave clear from Gate. Of course, you can't pressure tier 2, so Gate's not going to miss any CS pretty much ever again. Incarnation forced to back, he's out of mana.
Paulo knows he should be playing very safe right now, so his finger
very close. He's going to catch up to Sneaky. Here comes a lot of damage, and no spell shield comes through. Shen is not going to be enough. Oh my god, it is! He blocked the volley! Well, Apollo's alive, lost a lot of spells for it.
That's exactly why we talked about Cloud9 being hesitant to commit to one of these picks. The Shen, Stand United, and Soraka on the same team makes it really hard to 100% the person that you pick off. And they barely were able to pull it off. And that was only with Sneaky's damage. So
yeah.
If there was any sort of follow-up damage there from Cloud9.
I know, but it burned three ultimates and three summoner spells for two, basically. So a very big resource trade and close to dragon.
It was a great play.
Yeah.
But
you saw how hard it was.
This is how frustrating it is to play against two global savior moves, even though Apollo not able to get a meaningful spell shield.
Jeez.
Impact comes in just before the volley takes down Apollo. Man, Sneaky played that so well, too. The spell shield timed out before he shot his volley off, so he couldn't even have shot it earlier.
Yeah.
So as well as he could have possibly hoped for it.
What? But when you got three supports on one team, it's pretty good at keeping you alive. All right, so you can see the traditional stats for both these teams. Impulse normally much farther ahead than Cloud9 are in the early game, and sure enough, Impulse doing a good job.
And the thing is, too, that doesn't even really give Cloud9 that big of a window, because not only is Shen already past level 11, for the extra level in his ultimate, but he also had the cooldown reduction from Spirit Visage completed. It's almost back up, Sand United again. So, Impact.
Yeah, it's going to be up before Dragons.
Yeah, nothing.
It literally comes up
nothing
first.
Really lost there for them.
It's the summoners on Sivir. That's the big one. That's what they're really missing here. So it makes her a more tempting target. Yeah. Or easier.
Same thing with Ash. And I mean, she flashed forward.
Sinky did.
Does have heal advantage, but that is it.
We've got 15 seconds on Soraka's ulti. TP comes in. They're going to be looking to turn this one around. Cloud9 high, losing a bit of health. And right into the front line they go. Ball's taking a ton of damage. Says, you know what? This is not a fight I wanted after all.
Yeah.
Azir choke point's a bit bad.
You have to cancel that teleport because you're teleporting into a Soraka team as well who can lay down the silence on your arrival point. So very dangerous there from Balls, but he completes it and has to flash out anyway, losing them Dragon as well.
Yep. He's both playing slow and steady then. They haven't gotten a kill in a very long time, but all they've done is grow the gold lead. They're up still that roughly same 2,500-3,000 gold, but they're getting Dragons.
It will take a while if they want to work all the way towards number 5.
Yeah.
Because they started so late with it. But
42 minutes.
Definitely a possibility. They're also moving up their wards into Cloud9 territory, so they're starting to take over the map with the extra lead that they do have.
All right. Just playing the ward game. Impulse trying to move those lines up. Rush did upgrade a sweeper at level 9 basically right away. Mid lane does go down. Nicely done here by the rest of TIP. Ash was stuck in the bottom lane, sneaky pushing out a wave, so it gave control back over. Ash right now not answered yet. Apollo will show up late as he was there to help shove the mid wave in. That will give a bit of time for Sneaky to deal damage, but Impact on the flank. He said, oh, Sneaky did push in. That's cute. I'm Shannon. I'm going to kill you.
Yeah, Ash flashed forward last time, so.
No flash in red
heal, thought. Heals should not be enough to save Sneaky. Good luck.
Arrow.
Good luck, though.
He's going to? Yeah, okay. Apollo's actually missed spell shield on every arrow so far, though. I know it's hard, but that's a little bit troubling.
No complaints on ping either. 7 ping.
Yeah. I don't actually know what the actual ping on this tournament client is. I said 8 yesterday. Someone made a thread about it. Why is it 8 ping? It's on land. It's like, I was a number. I just picked one. I don't actually know what it is for these players.
We are seeing Impulse being rewarded, though, for moving up their vision there. That was why they knew there was no support for Sneaky. Not exactly sure why he was extended so far down, because Cloud9 should be very well aware of the coverage that Impulse have with their wards now. They've been multiple times into the Cloud9 jungle.
Yeah.
At this point, you have to play so much more careful with your Cloud9. Can't afford to extend and solo split push as Ash, especially.
Yeah. Well, if it's difficult situation shot calling you need, Hai is pretty much the expert. This man has orchestrated a lot of comebacks in his life. You wonder if it's going to be good enough for Cloud9 here.
Yeah, they're going to have to get, you know, a really good arrow pick or something with people in the area to add damage to it.
Yeah,
because they're definitely falling off as far as the team fight is considered. Hai definitely going to get outstripped here by Rush, who also had a great early game. So thought that the Rush versus Hai was going to be a big deal. And even when pushed over to Gragas,
Rush still came up huge. And now we're in a situation where there's a small timing window. Zeke's Harbinger is done first for elimination. And by the way, Ash, with this kind of support, with a Janna's shield and Zeke's, is a freaking ton of damage. C9 can try to set up a team fight before that mirror or that window is mirrored.
All right. Impulse are in a position to answer, though. Impact is ready with Stand United.
Take a lot of damage. Zeke's gonna trigger in a second. There it goes. Plenty of damage coming out from Ash. And there's the stun onto Rush. They're trying to slow him down and
look
finish
at 1,000. They got
They're
it.
Gonna get it. Now Gate locks the team into the pit. How's the second half of this fight gonna go? Sneaky has no flash, is jumped on, gonna take a lot of damage. Summon heal comes across, but the rest of the fight is Ball's going down. He was flashless, he was gonna be killed. Impact with the big play, the two-man taunt. Incarnation just does not do enough damage. He chooses to clear a minion wave with the rest of his life, but there's the taunt, there's the kill, there's the double. 3-for-1 for Baron.
Oh, what a juicy taunt there. 2 AD carries standing right next to each other without flashes for Impact.
And look at this by Impulse, peeling off exactly right. Gate goes mid lane, knocks the turret down. Top lane gonna go down to the rest of the team. Impulse get 2 turrets and 2 kills up for that Baron take.
Yeah, they should be able to get Inhibitor 1 as well, just to add.
Oh, wow.
So yeah, Baron definitely not worth it there for Cloud9.
It was a risk, and the risk did not pay off good. collapsed by Impulse there. The inhibitor itself actually going to fall. No Ash Arrows, no tools left. Impulse pulling very far ahead.
All right, well, with the Super Minions up top as well, even though Cloud9 have some Baron left, Impulse can definitely keep up the pressure. Cloud9's still going to be looking for someone to get caught off guard, though. Let's take another look at this. Balls, I think he walks into the soldier here. Oh, Rush body slams him into the Azir wall and gets knocked over.
Farther back.
Didn't matter anyways, because he was going to be the sacrifice so the rest of the team could get out anyway, but funny nonetheless. Lemonade, or Incarnation and Stinky had both used their flashes previously, so basically the dream for a Shen.
Yeah.
Double AD carry sitting right next to each other. He's even had his Thornmail completed as well.
Yeah. Impact's huge this game. Even though he's playing tanks kind of repetitively now for Impulse, I'm still surprised to see him not on carry champions like an Olaf or a Riven or whatnot, but his tank play has been solid. His standing net is very good.
Yep.
And he still threatens the back lines here.
Like what Impulse did here with the two defensive global ultimates. They really stymied the early game of Cloud9. And Cloud9 with all these pick tools, not able to make anything happen.
Yeah.
Rush in deep now.
But he's going to find Incarnation, knocks him into the silence field. Nothing to do. Wow! Just right. Wrecks him. Sneaky's gone. Lemonation's next. High's also in the sights. Big heal comes across. Lemon knocks the team back, and I guess they will buy a bit of time. But Balls now, the sole frontliner, will get them away from his turret.
You know what? I don't even know if banning champions against Rush even does anything anymore. That his Gragas has been really, really good this time around.
Yeah.
Big improvements there.
Well, at least we're going to see teams switch sides around, so maybe they can actually get Azir for themselves. That ended up being a pretty big factor for both these teams. Gate having something comfortable. We talked about him getting picked on early game, but never, ever dying.
He survived.
Zero death. Yeah. Impressive as hell by Gate for all the pressure on him, and he's a big teamfight factor now. All right. So definitely I think we'll see the plans switch up by Cloud9 in the next game, but right now it's just Impulse doing amazing things.
Get the arrow, but again, double. They got the silence field there and the slow field from Soraka. Fresh coming in to cut him off. Should be a pretty easy cleanup for game one for Impulse. Cloud9 definitely trying to think about what were the most frustrating parts of this game to fight against. Feel like the Shen might be targeted.
Yeah, I think you get rid of
Impact
the supporting cast.
Impact is his favorite. It's so heavily.
I totally agree. They target banned the main player, Rush, and I think the supporting cast might be more important here. We'll see if Soraka and Shen are added to the pool.
Yeah, very good signs for Impulse, by the way.
Absolutely.
People were getting a little bit worried for them, but Gate performing on something that's not Lulu, able to bring some late game damage now that he survive through the early game and the early pressure up high.
We'll see what they can do for the rest of the series then. What else these guys can do to push forward. Amumu, yes. I was actually a bit surprised not to see Shyvana banned at all, since that was what I was so successful on yesterday, but it looks like he wanted the Elise, he wanted a pressure, couldn't quite get enough of it.
Yeah, he's still, since it's still been a really recent return to the jungle for him, so that's why he's still trying all these different champions. He's trying to find, you know, what will be the most successful for him personally, because he doesn't have as much experience as all the other jungle mains on the more meta champions.
Been out for a couple of months, but still, it's definitely going to be difficult to all the old experience people had with Elise back in the day. But here comes the next fight. Impact running into the front line. He looks for Balls here, and it's going to be Rush.
Oh, they got him.
Taking a ton of damage. The shields come through. Rush is still not dead. Finally shut down the third kill, but it's all too late. Gate makes the big play. Knock a two back into the base. Does get knocked down. Incarnation finally finds some kills on the board here, but it's still Impulse knocking down way more than they're losing here. 2 for 3 so far. Into the base. Minions flooding in as well. Impact basically immune to damage here from Incarnation and Lemonation. Turret number one, turret number two, perfect fantasy score here for Team Impulse. And that's going to be the Nexus going down. 33 and a half minutes. One last fight. Impact refuses to die. There we go. 1-0 Impulse.
Yeah, 1-0 with a very relaxed and clean game from them.
Yeah.
That is what's going to happen if you have Soraka and Shen on the same team, though. Very relaxed defensive play.
Lots of saving.
Rush F5. Still able to make some decently early moves on Gragas.
Yeah.
Targeted the bot lane, as we suspected for. Sneaky on his Ashe. Repeatedly ganked.
It was interesting to see what Rush actually did, because he really never camped for the Shen lane. Didn't try that one at all. He somewhat helped gate, but not a ton until he was getting turret dive later on. And it was just set up in the bot lane. And it was interesting watching one of the first ganks come through, because the 2-on-2 down there was pretty much equal. C9 was mostly shoving. And then there was one slow push that TAP finally built. And Rush was already back there on Tribe Rush. And he's like, yep, the first time my team ever pushed into the turret, I'm going to dive them.
Yep.
And it was great.
No defensive wards either for Cloud9.
He rushed Nomad's Medallion and didn't buy any wards in the recall.
Well,
and, you know,
high either for the
that's
jungle
true.
To try and help out there.
All right, that one. See, I'm going to blame the jungler on that one. I don't mind the support getting gold income because it buys me a Zeke's Harbinger. Jungler has no use to me at all. It's just buy wards for my lane. Mm. That's my thrust.
See how you feel about that next time you die.
Either way, though, I mean, definitely a good game by Impulse. We saw their early game go quite well. Rush did a whole bunch of work, and then Gate was solid. Gate got picked on, and Gate still held up. So that was great to see from them. We're going to see what else these guys can do in the next game. We're going to hand it over to our analysts for a breakdown of that first win.